G'day guys, it's Andrew from Outdoor Gear Addict, and yeah, just wanted to do a quick video on, I guess, survival kits. And what I mean by survival kits is that kits that you would take out when you're in a situation where you wanted to effectively utilise the natural resources around you. So this is really about more like food gathering as opposed to, you know, fire and shelter and so forth. So, you know, I just wanted to kind of give you an insight into some of the stuff that I found that you may find useful. And this is the kind of plastic container kit that I always carry with me, regardless of the sort of mix and match of items within that. And now this particular product is produced by a company called Smash, and the reason why I love this plastic container system over here is that you can actually break it apart into a mix and match system. So I don't know if you can see that over here, but you've got these plastic joins over here, and that effectively allows you to kind of clip the container off, if you like, and then mix and match. So you can kind of elongate it or shorten it. It really depends on your needs. So, you know, it just gives you a lot of kind of, I guess, controls around, I guess, how big your container or your kit is. And, you know, it just, yeah, just it's really good from an organisational perspective, so you can just put stuff together. One of the big things that kind of attracted me about this container is the fact that it actually had a plastic kind of bulge system at the front. So, I mean, I think they actually utilized that for fruit. But the reason why that works so well as a kind of survival food container kit is that, you know, it carries your mechanical fishes really, really well. These things have a tendency to kind of bulge a little bit more. And, you know, if you're carrying sort of, you know, 5 or 6 mechanical fishes, as I do, then you will know that, you know, some of these things can be sort of fairly inhibited when it's kind of flat. And guys, if you've never been, if you've never been introduced to a mechanical fisher, or you've never used a mechanical fisher, these things are just the bomb. You know, absolutely must have in regards to kind of food gathering or in your food survival kit, if you like. If you haven't seen one of these before, check out the video by just clicking over here. Yeah, so, you know, putting the mechanical fishing kind of bits aside over here, what I'll usually carry too is, you know, some spare sort of backup fishing materials. So this is really kind of, you know, to a degree unnecessary, but it just forms another level of redundancy and make me sort of kind of completely self-reliant. So if I'm out there for a couple of weeks, you know, I can set lots of stuff. Bit of fishing line, some heavy gauge fishing line, pretty much redundant because those mechanical fishers do really such a great job, and when you lay those traps, you know that you'll be coming back to lots of fish. So, you know, again guys, highly recommend those things, mechanical fishers. But in here, what I also carry with me is, it's just basically a short handy tool. I always keep that in there. It just makes it easier to pull the hooks out of fish's mouths and so forth, and you know, basically some basic items just to kind of support that fishing kit. So, you know, what I always carry in every situation is I always carry these kind of lead weighted pallets, and the reason why I prefer these over any other source is, first off, you can clip them together, and B, if you're not actually fishing, you can actually use these as shot, particularly when you've got a swing. So very, very handy stuff. So that's basically, you've got some lead shot over there. Over here, just some swivels, makes things nice and easier, especially if you're doing a whole lot of bank lining type stuff. You know, a lot of kind of prefabricated line over there, big hooks, small hooks, medium hooks and so forth, and just another range of hooks there. And over here, just some sort of artificial bait. So this is really very, very handy. And as I said, from a fishing point of view, I mean, really, between this box over here and the mechanical fishers, you know, that's all really you're pretty going to need. So, you know, these other items are just kind of redundant luxury kind of items, really, at the end of the day. But I just kind of chuck them in because it's good to have them as backup. Now, on this side of the container over here, at the moment, I've kind of got it set up as more of a kind of fishing kit system, so you know, I've got other bits and pieces in there. Really, just more like floats that I kind of have over there, and they're kind of handy just to obviously utilize in kind of different kind of fishing environments, and again, you know, just more you know, artificial bait over there that I have. So it just makes life really, really easy when I'm sort of going out there, and you know, I can be lazy at times. No need to put more effort into catching food if you don't need to. But when I don't have it set up in such a way, what I will do is I'll always carry some snag line over there. So you know, that's just effectively some wire trap line that'll sit in there, and you know, that'll already kind of cover, you know, most of my, you know, natural food gathering requirements very, very easily in one very simple organized container. And the great thing about this container system over here is that in fact it'll fit into the front pocket of an Alice bag. So you know, very, very handy in that sort of sense once again, you know, and they're pretty lightweight as well. So this thing is probably just over a kilo, so you know, 2.2 pounds if you're looking at an English or American kind of conversions. But yeah, you know, pretty handy considering that, you know, you can get out there, you can lighten your food load quite considerably, and you know, eat fresh food. So pretty handy. Before I head off, I wanted to introduce you to a bit of kit that a guy I met is actually developing, and this bit of survival kit that he's producing kind of makes a lot of sense. I'm really quite chuffed about it, and he sort of provided me one to have a review, and I'll just show it to you in shot. So, you know, this is obviously the kind of larger, more comprehensive kind of fishing kit over here. And really, I mean, I don't even really need that section over there. It's not really required. Those mechanical fishes, though, are just an absolute godsend and really handy. And if you've got five or six of them, you're going to eat like a king. And, you know, obviously that can be handy too, just in regards to if you're, you know, getting more comprehensive and doing a wild trap. But if you're just using kind of standard fishing stuff and you're not interested necessarily in carrying something as weighty as that, which is, you know, as I said, a good kilo, you know, this little micro survival fishing kit is an absolute, it's an absolute option. The guy's just done a really, really good job of it, and I think that, you know, it's really, really logical and really amazing, and considering the size, it's just, yeah, kind of super cool. There's just lots of kind of redundancy in there, and you know, I'll just show you very, very quickly. If you want to see the full review on it, you know, just wait to the end and click on the link there. But just a bit of a sneak peek. Lots of redundancy on lots of level. This is, as I said before, it's a survival / fishing kit. Basically, it's just a small little pack. This thing's about 4 inches wide, so about 55 millimeters and about an inch thick. And it kind of opens up, and it functions as a survival and a really very, very comprehensive fishing kit over here. So very handy if you're anywhere near water. So it's got basically lots of redundancy in regards to fire lining, a ferrocerium rod, you know, you've got a Bic lighter over here. You've got multiple sources of lighting, you've got micro light, you've got tinders, you know, got compass and thermometers and a whole lot of fishing stuff in there as well, some, you know, lead pellets too. So if you're keen on looking at that review, click over here. If you like the review in general, you know, click subscribe.